الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما وعملا وخلاصا لك رب العالمين. As we are continuing with the seerah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Inshallah, from now on we're going to have the seerah right after Salat al-Maghrib. So we can inshallah spread the word and let the people know that it's not anymore after Salat al-Isha, it's going to be after Salat al-Maghrib. So this way for other brothers and sisters who have children, wants to go to school or have working days, inshallah we'll give them time and not hold them up. We will continue inshallah talking about the akhlaq al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the characters of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Among his character that he was very truthful. He was honest all the time, all his life. Not even one time he lied in his life. Not a single time he lied in his life, neither when he was young, neither when he was a messenger. Not even his childhood, a little later. So he was known by As-Sadiq al-Amin, the truthful, the trustworthy. When he was about 20 years old, the Prophet ﷺ, he helped with a battle called Harb al-Fujar. What's Harb al-Fujar? We talked about it in the previous classes, that al-Nasi, if you remember a few classes before, we talked about al-Nasi, that it's a battle or a fight that takes place during the forbidden month. There are 4 months in a year that is not allowed to start a fight. You can defend yourself, but you're not allowed to initiate a fight. You can fight back to defend yourself, to defend your family, but you're not allowed to initiate or start a fight. When he was 20 years old, there was a tribe called Hawazim. Hawazim attacked Quraysh during the month of Hurum. So Quraysh has the right to defend themselves and to defend the people of Mecca. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in the authentic hadith, كُنْتُ أَنْبُلُ لِأَعْمَامِ فِي يَوْمُ الْفُجَارِ. So he helped during that fight to protect the people of Mecca, to protect the families and Mecca itself. So Prophet said, I used to help and support my uncles by ambul. It has two meanings. One of them that I used to protect my uncle from any arrow to hit them, or another one, give my uncles the arrow so they can shoot the enemy. From this, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was put in a position to learn, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught him and put him in that position to teach him how the fight starts and how does it take a place, to put him in that position so he can get the experience. As Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "Adabani Rabbi fa ahsana ta'dibi," that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught me and corrected me and in the best way, right from his childhood all the way until he delivered the message, until he died, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was taking care of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by teaching him step by step and preparing him to be a messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he prepared him, he put him in that position so he knows how the fight takes place, what to do, how, what the enemy will do, how to can protect yourself, and so on and so forth. Also, among the things that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he did, this is all before the prophecy, before he became a messenger, he helped and he was taking part of Hilf al-Fudul. What is Hilf al-Fudul? Hilf al-Fudul, it is a treaty where, I'll tell you the story, the reason why it was called Hilf al-Fudul and why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam took part of that. Hilf al-Fudul, there was a story behind that one, that a man from Yemen, He used to have merchants and he used to bring it to Mecca to sell it. Businessman. So he sold it to Al-As ibn Wa'il. Al-As ibn Wa'il is the father of Amr ibn al-As. So he sold it to Al-As ibn Wa'il. And he was one of the rulers and one of the leaders of Mecca. Al-As ibn Wa'il, he was, after he took the merchants, he did not give him the money. He was procrastinating. He told him tomorrow, the after tomorrow, come back later, we'll do it after. And this is one of the evil things that when you commit to something, finish it to the end. Do not procrastinate and don't delay. And this is one of the things that Prophet ﷺ said in the hadith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he loves when someone do something to finish it and to perfect it and to complete it to the end. In Allah, يُحِبُّ إِذَا عَمِلَ أَحَدُكُمْ عَمَلًا أَنْ يُتْقِنَ. Itqan is perfected and finishing. So Al-As ibn Wa'il, he did not give him the money. Zulm. The man, he's a foreigner. He came to the Makkah. He has no supporter. He has no family. He has no one to help him out. So Al-As, he said, okay, maybe I can rip him off and take his money. So he came to him, this man, and he asked him, give me my money. I want to go back to my hometown. He wouldn't give it to him. Finally, he came to him and he told him, look, are you going to give me my money or not? He said, no. What are you going to do? Do whatever you want to do. I'm not giving you your money. So what he did, he went to Darul Nadwa. Darul Nadwa, where Quraysh was having their meeting. All the leaders of Quraysh were having their meeting. So he went and he started saying a few poems. He did a few poems, he said them, few of them, and in those poems, complaining about the dhulm, the oppression, and complaining about how Al-As ripped them off. And he said to Quraysh, if you guys gonna be quiet and not do something about it, you guys are part of it, part of the crime. And I will expose you in the whole Arab region. Quraysh, it was a shame for them. How could that possible? That someone talked about us and exposed us and saying bad things about us. We are the masters, we are the leaders. No one should talk about us. They had that pride. So what they did is, few guys, three of them, all of them, the names al-Fudul, al-Fudul, al-Fudul. So that's why they call them al-Fudul. Al-Fudul, the three Fuduls, three guys, the names al-Fudul, they got together and they said, we gonna make a group to protect the oppressed people, regardless whether they're from our family, whether they're from Mecca or outside of Mecca. Whoever been oppressed, we gonna support them and help them to get his haq back. So they got together, and also another reason why they call it al-Fudul, because al-Fudul also in the Arabic, it means that the rights, returning the rights. So those three guys came and they start calling in Mecca. Who would join us for this? Who would take part of this and help us to return the rights for the oppressed people, to stop the oppression? Many people came and start joining part and taking part of this group. So a lot of them they came, and Prophet ﷺ was one of them who came and joined that group and to return the haq to people's right. They went to Al-As and they agreed that we will return the haq even if it will cost us our life. We will die to make sure that we return the haq for the people. So everyone took his sword and they went to the Al-As. Al-As, Ibn Wa'il, he was one of the leaders, one of the masters in Mecca. He saw all this group of people coming to him and told him that we got together and we met, that you took the money from this guy, you don't give him back his money. If you don't, We will kill you. So when he saw this group of people and everybody going against him, he got scared. So he went and he brought his money and he gave it to the guy, and the man went back to his home. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the hadith, and this treaty and this group continued before Islam and even after Islam. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he accepted it. He did not change it. He kept it the way it is to return to the haq for the people. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the authentic hadith, he said, قَدْ دُعِيتُ فِي الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ إِلَى حِلْفْ لَوْ دُعِيتُ إِلَيْهِ فِي الْإِسْلَامِ لَأَجَبْ. He said, I've been called to join or take part of a treaty before Islam. Had I been called for the same cause, I would reply and respond to it without hesitation, any meaning of that. So that means he confirmed it and he accepted. And this is also a lesson for us that sometimes we have to take part of justice regardless of our religion, our deen, our ethnic background, regardless who we are, what we are, that we're supposed to stay with the haq, we're supposed to stay with the right. Whether we want to help a Muslim or a non-Muslim, if a person is being oppressed, we should help him. If someone is in danger, we should help him. It doesn't mean that we only help Muslims. Yes, we help Muslim and non-Muslim, we help humanity. This is a lesson that we should learn from the Prophet ﷺ, as Prophet ﷺ confirmed this treaty. So inshallah ta'ala, next week we'll talk about a very major incident that took place inshallah with Khadija radiallahu anha, and we'll continue inshallah next week. JazakAllah khair.